In this video, I will demonstrate ADMonitor, an optional component that is part of EventSentry that detects and monitors all Active Directory changes, provides it with before and after values for all attributes that were changed, monitors group policy changes, and also provides you with a complete inventory of all Active Directory user accounts. Now, EventSentry already includes some basic Active Directory monitoring even without the ADMonitor component. With EventSentry, you can detect user account changes, so you can see when a user was added or removed. Group changes, same thing, groups added, removed, membership changes, and so forth, and computer account changes. But compared with the ADMonitor component, the base functionality is somewhat limited. We can't monitor any object, we can't give you before and after values, and in order to monitor all Active Directory objects, auditing has to be enabled and can generate really a lot of noise. So ADMonitor addresses all of these shortcomings. It gives you complete visibility into Active Directory activity. It has no measurable impact on the monitor domain, and you're not required to enable any sort of auditing, with some small exceptions on determining who made a particular change. It can be installed on any domain member, so it does not have to be installed on the domain controller. And again, it's a product, it's a component that's included in EventSentry. So there's no separate product. It has to be downloaded, installed, and maintained. It's all part of the solution that you hopefully are already using. But let's take a look at ADMonitor, starting with the installation. Since ADMonitor is included in EventSentry, there's no extra setup installer to run. So all you need to do is enable a checkbox during the installation and select the password for the user account that's being used by ADMonitor to actually communicate with the domain controllers. Once ADMonitor is installed, there's a dialog in the management console, and I'm going to jump to that right now. That gives you an overview of the status of the service. It does a health check right here, and it you configure where the Active Directory changes, which database they're going to be written to. So the setup is incredibly easy. There is further customizations that you can make, for example, exclude certain changes, issue email alerts, and so forth with a additional utility that's called the EventSentry ADMonitor Administrator, but I'll cover that in a separate video. So for the time being, just know that the installation is incredibly easy. There's nothing to do other than check a checkbox and type in a password. So once ADMonitor is installed, what do you get? Most of the information that ADMonitor provides is going to be in the web reports. It's going to be under the search menu in the ADMonitor section right here. Let's start with the users. So here we have the familiar summary page of the user list. So this gives us a list of all the user accounts in Active Directory in this test domain. We have certain sections here that are very interesting. For example, how many admins do we have in the domain? So we have 2 out of 54. And here the bar indicates this, the percentage here. How many disabled user accounts do we have? How many users have passwords that never expire? How many have expired passwords? How many users must change their password to the next login, and how many are logged out? Let's take a look, for example. Let's say we wanted to make a change here, right? So we have a user whose password never expires. Actually, we have 53 user accounts whose password never expires. So let's click that, and here it's now filtered. We have this option set here, password never expires, yes. Let's click on detailed. So all of these user accounts are set for the password to never expire. Let's just say we wanted to change this for any one of them. Well, I'm going to go into the user accounts. So here we have a ADMonitor test users OU that I had created for testing purposes. And let's these are all inventors whose first and last names were mixed together randomly. All right. So for example, here we have, all right, let's pick our favorite, of course, Kirkpatrick Tesla. Let's take a look at the account properties. And indeed, it says password never expires. So we're going to clear that. So ADMonitor should pick this up. And let's go into Carl Tesla here as well. He also needs to have a password that expires. So if you go back now, so where can we see these changes? So In the AD Monitor section, under Optic Changes, is where we can see changes that were made to user optics. And you can already see here, we have two changes here in the last 24 hours, the ones that I just touched. So I'm going to click on Detailed, because we want to see what actually changed. We can see that the object that was changed was user. It was modified. It was modified by the administrator. That's the user account I'm logged in with. And let's click. So we see some of the attributes here, but we can't fit all of them in this report. So if you click this little button here, we can see, okay, the user account control attribute was changed from don't expire password and being a normal account to just being a normal account. So you can see exactly what changed. We can also see that an additional attribute was initialized here. So you have complete visibility as to what's going on here. Let's go back. So with just a few clicks, we can see exactly which user accounts were changed and what was changed. But we can't just monitor user accounts. Let's go down here. I created a test OU called AD Monitor Live Demo. And I'm going to create a new sub OU. I'm going to call it Excellent Inventors. I'm going to go back here. I'm going to move some of these, the ones that I just changed, I'm going to move them into this OU. I'm going to say move here. Yes, yes, yes. And go back to the Active Directory changes. I'm going to actually go back to the summary page. And as to be expected, we have the Excellent Inventors OU here. And we can see here, okay, well now we have a new class name that's appearing. We have a change that affected an organizational unit. And we have two additional changes that were made to those two user objects. So let's take a look what changed. So first, of course, we can see that the organizational unit was created. And there's not much to show here. We can look at the details here. And there's, of course, a bunch of attributes that Windows creates in the background. But overall, that's really not that relevant. We just know that the object was created. And then we can see that the path for those user accounts was changed. It was changed from the AD Monitor test users organizational unit. We can see that it was moved to Excellent Inventors in the AD Monitor live demo. So every change that's being made to an object is going to be recorded. But now let's take a look at group policy changes. I'm here in the group policy objects container. So this is where all the group policy objects are stored. I have a AD Monitor demo video group policy already here that I'm going to change. So we're going to right click. I'm going to say edit. Let's go into policies, Windows settings. And these are where a lot of common settings are being changed. Let's take a look at local policies. Let's take a look at user rights assignments. Let's say I wanted to change that, and we're going to allow, and I don't recommend this, but I'm just going to say domain users here are going to be allowed to debug programs. So now let's take a look. Let's go back to our search page, object changes. All right, we can see, all right, there was a group policy change. Let's filter our output. We're just concerned with group policy changes at the moment. And of course, you can create reports based on that as well, right? So any sort of change, if you want to get a daily email about all user account changes, all user accounts being deleted or created or whatnot, you can do all of that with the web reports easily, and supports different formats as well. But let's look at these details here. So we know that a group policy was changed. Now, keep in mind, group policy consists of a object in Active Directory, but it also has an associated group policy file that's being changed. So this is just the object in Active Directory that was changed. So if we look at it here, we can basically just see that the version number was increased. If we want to see the details, then we can click this button here or the button in the pop-up dialog. So I'm just going to use this button here. It's faster. And now let's take a look. So what was changed? So here, the AD Monitor demo video policy was changed. Change type is new, so that means a new setting was added to the policy. We can see the full path of what we changed. Local policies, user rights assignments, debug programs, is the actual setting that was changed, and it was initialized, so there was no before value, and now we have domain users. Now if I go in and say, oh my goodness, I really don't want this, I'm going to remove this, and instead I'm going to say domain admins and click OK and hit the search button again, then we'll see, okay, this time the value was already there, so it was changed, and it changed from domain users to domain admins. And note that now we're no longer in the object changes dialog, we're in the group policy changes dialog. So this is pretty neat. So you can see any change that was made to a group policy. So gone are the days when you're guessing, well, who made this change? Why is this there? You have complete visibility. You have a complete history of any object change that was made in Active Directory. So this is, of course, important for compliance purposes, for security purposes, and just for operations, so you know who's making changes and what's going on in Active Directory. Without something like ADMonitor, you really don't know who's making changes, and you really don't have a great deal of oversight to a very important component of your operating system, of your network. Now let's take one last look at the user's inventory. I wanted to show you a few other useful reports. If you look to the top right of the screen, you'll see a little document icon with the number 1 next to it. So what that means is that this page has a report configured for it. Your installation, if you install EventSentry, you'll actually have more than this. This is a demo network where I only have this one specific report, but you click that, and here you can see that there's a report called Users Who Have Not Logged On in 45 Days. So when I click that, I get 51 users. So since these are all test users that have never logged on, you can see that they have not logged, that we have 51 user accounts who have not logged on. So this is really great if you wanted to weed out user accounts that are no longer in use. Organizations change, users come and go, and very often user accounts get left behind, sometimes even active. So with this report, you can easily, you can change this number here, right? So if you wanted to say, well, actually, I want to know who hasn't logged on in 20 days, because there really is no reason for somebody to not log on in 20 days. So in this case, the report didn't change, it's the same number. But you can use this to find accounts of users who have left the organization, contractors who were maybe at one point given access to the network. So this is indispensable, and this is something that you should schedule as a report and probably get emailed every day or every week, depending on the size of your network. So how do you get ADMonitor? You can either download a trial of EventSentry. So if you haven't tried EventSentry yet, give it a try. Download the 30-day trial. It's free. It comes with full support and includes ADMonitor as well as NetFlow. If you're already running EventSentry and you don't have ADMonitor, then you can simply head to your account area, log in, and request an ADMonitor trial there as well. So this is going to be valid for 30 days as well. You'll get a license key emailed to you that you can just essentially add to your list, to your license key, to your existing license keys, and that will enable ADMonitor. The only prerequisite, of course, is that you're running EventSentry 4.0 or later. Thank you for watching. I hope you like the additional functionality that ADMonitor brings to EventSentry. And stop by again soon for future videos about EventSentry. Thank you.